Good morning, and happy Father's Day to all of our fathers out there. It is a wonderful, beautiful day to celebrate. How many have outdoor plans today? Yes, everyone's hand should be up, even if it's just walking outside to your car. That is outdoor plans. For those of you who do not know me, my name is Reverend Jessica Brendler Naulty, and I serve here as the senior pastor at Clinton United Methodist Church, and it's an honor and privilege to do so. We're so glad that you are here worshiping with us today, either here in person or joining us online. Happy Sunday. We pray that this service brings you closer to God and to each other. Before we greet one another in the peace and love of Christ, which we'll do in just a moment, I'm going to introduce our new sermon series because you have a task to do during our passing of the peace. So today, we are kicking off a new 4-week sermon series called The Well-Played Life, where we'll delve into one game a week and see what life lessons are taught through the game, and then hold them up to the teachings of our faith to see how they line up. Through this series, we hope to have a little bit of fun, be a little bit playful in worship, recognizing and celebrating the fact that pleasing God and worshiping God doesn't always have to be so much serious work. Amen? Are you giggling at me? Okay, that's allowed. I invite you now to rise and greet one another, and as you do so, share with the people you are greeting one favorite childhood game that you remember playing as a kid, and maybe you still like playing today. All right, let's greet one another.
Good morning. Let us open our worship this morning with a prayer. Please join me. Holy and wondrous God of us all, we gather this day to praise your name and give thanks for the blessings of life. Come, O Holy Spirit, and bless us with strength, healing, hope, joy, a playful spirit, and renewed faith. May this time of worship be filled with joy and abundant grace, that we may be filled to overflowing for the week ahead. Amen. And now let us rise as you are able and sing our opening hymn, Come Christians Join to Sing, number 158 in the hymnal.
Good morning. I'm Beth Crawford. I'm on staff here at Clinton UMC, and whether you're here with us in person or online, welcome. It's good to have you with us. If you're looking for a way to make a difference or get more connected with us here at Clinton UMC, we have a lot of volunteering opportunities. I'm going to talk about three this morning. First, kids camp. I want to talk about play and joy. It is a joyful time. We host a lot of kids from outside of the walls of this church, so it is a really great opportunity for us to kind of connect with the community. It's one of our bigger outreach events. It takes a lot of volunteers, and it's a fun, if you are available during the day, it's a fun way to get plugged in. Contact the church office for details. You can also help, though, even if you can't come during the day to hang out with the kids. If you invite your family and friends, then we can have like an even bigger party. We do have postcards. I don't think they're in the bulletin, but we have some in the back. Grab a postcard if you have a friend that you want to invite. Next. Our thrift shop is serving more people than ever. And if you would like to help join the effort that we put forth to make sure our community has high quality, reasonably priced clothing and home goods, you can contact Elaine Pete or the church office, and we can tell you a little bit more about that opportunity. There are lots of times available, so you can pick a time that works for you. And if you grab a coffee or a snack after church, and you should, you know that our coffee hour is a great time of connection. and his staff, like our other volunteers, by people who really have a heart for service. So if you would like to help with this type of hospitality, you can stop by the kitchen after the service, you can speak with the host, or you can talk to the care committee lead, who is Nancy Smith. Thanks for listening, and now it's children's time.
Good morning. As Jess mentioned, we are looking for volunteers for children's camp over the summer. So we're going to show a video of one of our past kids' camps to show you guys some of the joy and the fun that is had at camp over the summer. And when the video is done, our kids can line up in the back to come downstairs for Sunday school.
As our children make their way on back for children's time, I do want to invite Laura Tonzatich up to share an announcement with us as our SPRC chair.
Good morning. Thank you, Jess. Yes, my name is Laura Tonzatich. I am your SPRC chair. You can exhale the breath you might be holding right now at this time of year. First of all, thrilled to announce that Pastor Jess has been officially reappointed as our pastor for the coming year. So, I know, I can see on your faces, you're like, here we go. So no, she'll be back, which is great. But I do have some important updates concerning our children's and ministry youth leadership roles that I want to share with you today. So as many of you know, our various youth programs throughout the years have had seasons where attendance has been bursting at the seams, and times, especially after COVID, where those numbers have really fluctuated. Currently, we're blessed with an increasing numbers in our elementary school age attendees, but we are experiencing a gap with our middle and high school students. It was a joy to celebrate our graduating seniors last week, but this leaves us in a season of growth. For that reason, SBRC is recommending a merger of the two positions into one role entitled Director of Children's and Youth Ministry. This single position will hopefully tie the elementary Sunday school programming together with the middle and high school experiences and mission opportunities. As you already know, Jess Vega is transitioning out of her role serving our middle and high school students, but this merger of positions also impacts our current children's ministry leader, Faith Evers. I need to share with you today that Faith has decided to resign from that position as well. Since 2019, Faith has blessed us with her talents in children's ministry. As the lead teacher for our Sunday school groups, Faith welcomed our youngest members with love and presented foundational Bible lessons with creative activities and crafts. As you just saw, our summertime kids camp was an amazing and continues to be amazing experience. The annual Christmas pageant are both beloved traditions that Faith has skillfully directed with enthusiasm. I have to give her special credit to anyone who can convince my son to sing and play handbells while wearing a donkey costume. She gets a lot of props for that. I can't even get him to sing a song with me. So I know I'm not alone either in the joy that fills my heart when we look out and see the entire congregation doing the hand motions to Peace Like a River in some of our children's times. It's really, she's been such a blessing for all of us. We want to thank Faith for her service to our young people and also our entire church community. We wish her great success. She recently graduated and has starting a new career in equine therapy at the Ivy Hill Therapeutic Equestrian Center in Percassie, Pennsylvania. Her leadership will be missed, but she'll now be able to focus her energy on helping others through her role as a therapist. And we know that she'll continue to be a blessing to so many in all she does. As we progress through the hiring process, SPRC welcomes your questions, but especially your time and talents. We do not know exactly how long it might take to find a good fit for this role, one that will serve our children as faithfully as Jess Vega and Faith Evers have. We appreciate your help with our summer programming. Go Kids Camp, everybody. You're all coming to help out. and our children's ministries. And finally, we ask for your prayers that this change will continue to provide all of our young people with the enriching experiences that our children's and youth programs have always offered. So thank you for your time.
Good morning. Happy Father's Day. Thanks to a long line of fathers who came before us, right? So obviously we all wish Faith the best of luck on her journey, and we all have our own journey. And for me, mine and my gift is music, and for me it's like prayer. So I wrote this song called Head of a Pin. It's basically kind of like a prayer for me. Whoa, 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 mm-hmm. Whoa, whoa, whoa. to concentrate on one thing, the eye of a needle, a butterfly's wing, a fiber of paper, the weave of the cloth, a hummingbird's heart, and the speed of a sloth. Go slower, move closer to the head of a pin, to the angels within. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Give yourself over to something green, the veins of a leaf, nature's machine, the fiddlehead fern as it starts to unfurl. Reach for the sky, see your place in this world, and go slower, move closer to the head of a pin, to the angels within. Because the world goes by so fast. Yeah, the world goes by so fast. Put yourself into the space between stone and the start of a diamond, between muscle and bone, to the edge of beginning, to just a moment before it gets put into motion and becomes so much more. And go slower, move closer to the head of a pin, to the angels within. Whoa, whoa, mm-hmm. Whoa, 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 mm-hmm. Whoa.
Thank you, Andrew. Our choir wrapped up their service for the season last week, so we get to now shift into our summer of special music. So thank you, Heather, for lining up and working on lining up any of the special music. Do you still need people, or do you have enough? Okay. If you have something that you would really like to offer in special music, you can speak with Heather. Go ahead and raise your hand. And if there's two in one Sunday, we can deal with that too, right? So as we move into our prayer time, I just do want to remind you that the booklets that were passed in the pews during the announcement time had a prayer card in them. If you have any prayers that you would like to invite others to be in prayer with you on, any joys, celebrations, anything that's weighing you down, you are invited to fill out that prayer card and place that in the offering plate later on in the service. We have an email prayer list that goes out every Monday. If you would like to receive that and join in the prayer life of the congregation, you can leave your contact information in that offering plate as well. So now let us move our hearts together into a time of prayer. God of all creation, we join our voices to praise you today and celebrate the joys of life you have blessed us with. Family and friends, new and deepening relationships, new life and transformed lives, reconciliation and restoration, community and your abiding love. On this day, we are especially grateful for the gift of fathers. We thank you for the many ways that our fathers have shaped us, for their example and their love. For those whose father's presence is greatly missed, may we take time to gratefully recall all they have given to us. For those who have recently lost or are facing the imminent loss of fathers, may they find comfort in their grief, hope in their despair, courage in the love they received through them. We pray for those who have had difficult or estranged relationships between father and child, for those situations of abuse or neglect. God of healing, pour out your grace to bind up places of brokenness of heart, spirit, and relationship. We pray too for those who have been wanting to be fathers and not given the opportunity, for those whose years of parenting have been cut short by the loss of a child. We turn to you, most holy God, knowing, trusting that you can console where consolation seems impossible. May those who need healing receive comfort for their soul and peace and hope for living, that their gifts may not be denied to others. Finally, O God, we rejoice with you at the many fine men who have taken their place as fathers by blood or by choice, with open hearts, with willingness and joy. And we join all fathers everywhere in praying that their children may be well and happy and a source of joy for years to come. Hear our prayers this day, O God, those spoken aloud and those lifted from the silence of our hearts, and help us to trust that your love, healing, strength, and resurrection power will be with us today and all days. In your holy name we pray, amen. And now we lift our voices together to pray the prayer that Jesus taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven,
This morning's scripture is taken from Luke 12, verses 13 through 21. Someone in the crowd said to him, Teacher, tell my brother to divide the family inheritance with me. But he said to him, Friend, who set me to be a judge or an arbitrator over you? And he said to them, Take care. Be on your guard against all kinds of greed. For one's life does not consist in the abundance of possessions. Then he told them a parable. The land of a rich man produced abundantly. And he thought to himself, What should I do? For I have no place to store my crops. Then he said, I will do this. I will pull down my barns and build larger ones. And there I will store all my grain and my goods. And I will say to my soul, Soul, you have ample goods laid up for many years. Relax, eat, drink, be merry. But God said to him, You fool, this very night your life is being demanded of you. And the things you have prepared, whose will they be? So it is with those who store up treasures for themselves, but are not rich towards God. May God bless the reading, hearing, and understanding of this word. Amen.
Thank you. So I grew up in a family that was and still is today big, game players. Every year we would get at least one new game for Christmas and add it to our overflowing game closet. You should see mine at the parsonage. Sorry. In the summers or any school break, my sisters and I would gather around the table and play game after game. Double solitaire, spit, war, pinochle, Scrabble, Monopoly, backgammon, encore, Trivial Pursuit, Jenga, just to name a few. While we played, we would talk and laugh, bicker and fight like siblings do so well. We would win or lose and then start again. Each game has its own set of rules and instructions, its own end goal and purpose. Often, not always, but often, to finish with the most points or the most money. Today, we are kicking off this new series called The Well-Played Life, where we're delving into games and learning lessons from them. And today, we're starting with the game of life. Just gonna put that right there and hope it doesn't fall over. The goal in the Milton Bradley Game of Life is to make it to the end with the highest accumulated value. Just out of curiosity, I'm going to do it the opposite. Has anyone not played the Game of Life? Sorry. I love you all very much. And I might send this home with you and give you homework. No, I'm kidding. So y'all need to listen up because you win by getting to the end with the highest accumulated value. Now, your wealth might be in cash on hand, invested in your real estate, or collected through life tokens, which represent the random acquisitions of money along the way. Different choices and strokes of luck determine how much you will be able to accumulate. Did you choose to go to college or start working right away? What kind of career did you end up with? And how much did you make? How many kids do you have? And how many spaces along the board did you land on that added to or subtracted from your overall wealth? There's paydays, insurance, stocks, investments, lawsuits, and even wagering on games of chance, which of course you don't do that if you're Methodist. Did you know that the original version of this game was called the Checkered Game of Life? And it was first released in 1860 by Milton Bradley himself. Instead of spaces on the board you find today, like get in a car accident or car stolen or adopt a cat, the original had spaces like disgrace, ruin, crime, prison, and even suicide. It sounds like a super cheerful game. No matter the specifics of the spaces, being a winner in the game of life is all about finishing first, having the most money, retiring to millionaire estates rather than countryside estates. I don't know, I always wanted to be in the countryside estates myself. The sad thing is that many people think that this is what real life is about too. That to be a winner in real life, a person must achieve those same goals: possessions, power, position, prestige. And our culture, with its sleek advertising campaigns, is only too quick to reinforce this kind of thinking. The world tells us that the winners are those with status and clout. People with the biggest house, the fastest, coolest car, and the most money. The strong ones, the beautiful ones, the skinny ones, the young ones. Whether we like it or not, as a culture, we've bought in to this board game mentality of life. After all, who doesn't want to be considered a winner by those around them? But instead, we all lose as we struggle to keep up with the Joneses. In James Carse's book, Finite and Infinite Games, he describes two kinds of games which reveal different ways of approaching life. He said there are finite games and infinite games. Finite games have fixed rules, known boundaries in which the game is played, a board, a field, a time limit, and the number and identity of players is known. There's a winner and there's a loser. The object of a finite game is to win. And when someone wins, the game is over. Infinite games, however, are different. There may not be rules, and if there are, they often change during the game. The playing field is boundless. There is no time limit. The players are numberless and often unknown. The object of an infinite game is not to win, but to keep playing. To keep the game going with a goal much bigger than winning or losing. Now, there's nothing wrong with board games and finite game mentality. There's nothing wrong with Milton Bradley's The Game of Life. But we need to remember that they are finite. And our life is infinite. The decisions we make in life don't go away after an hour of play, but they can have long-term effects on us and those around us. You don't win parenting. You don't win your marriage. You don't win your friendships and relationships. You don't win your career. You don't win your life, love, faith, or God. Real life deals in the infinite. You take one day at a time, you remain present, you grow, and you step into the infinity that is life and eternal life. You show up in all sorts of circumstances, the good and the bad, the difficult and the easy, the desired and the unwanted, the joyful and the sorrowful, and you keep the game going, doing your best. It's about becoming fully alive, becoming our truest, most authentic selves, most faithful selves, living faithfully with the life we've been gifted and sharing what we can with others. Throughout the Gospels, Jesus is leading us to live this infinite game of life. Through his teachings and parables, his admonitions and invitations, he is trying to help us see the bigger picture. The meaning and the end goal of life is not found in the accumulation of possessions or power or prestige. Rather, it is found in faithfulness to God and living out God's love. In our gospel reading today, we hear the story that's lovingly been titled The Rich Fool. Such a great title. About a landowner whose fields have produced such good harvest that his barns are not big enough to store his crops. But rather than giving some away or selling it, possibly when the market was flooded, who knows, the price would have been too low to make a good profit, he decides to tear down his barns and build bigger one. Little did he know that he would die just after construction was completed, not giving him the chance to benefit from the wealth he was storing away in bigger and bigger barns. Jesus reminds us through this rich fool that in the infinite game of life, the goal is not accumulation, but it's about what you do with what you have and the relationships you build with God and others along the way. Just a few verses later, Jesus says, "Sell your possessions and give alms. Make purses for yourselves that do not wear out, an unfailing treasure in heaven where no thief comes near and no moth destroys. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also." As we go about and play our games of life this week, I invite you to reflect on all the moving pieces that make up your infinite game of life. Your education, your career, your family and possessions, the choices and chances you encounter along the way. And I invite you to give thanks for all the gifts that surround you, not taking a single thing for granted. Rather than always focusing on bigger, better, newer, cooler, more, allow Jesus to guide you to place your attention and treasures where they really matter, in loving God and loving others, building relationships and serving others. May we play this infinite game of life with this higher goal in mind. For if we do, we will all come out as beloved and blessed, winners in God's eyes. Amen. Amen. Our song today, our song of reflection, is all about where God is with us in this journey and how God invites us to live in relationship with others, with our possessions, and serving others. It may be a familiar one, it may not be, but I invite you to enjoy the song and the lyrics especially. Let us rise and sing "When the Poor Ones," number 434, in English only. Thank you.
invite you to be seated.
Okay, so it was not a well-known one. I get it. Great words, though. Great, great words. In this unfolding game of life, we're invited to take part in God's work and kingdom building through offering of our time and talents and treasures. As our ushers come forward and come around with the offering plates, may our generosity overflow and empower our church to continue being a beacon of hope in our community. Don't forget to place any prayer cards you have in the offering plates as they are passed. And may we offer our hearts with love and with joy. Amen.
Great God of gifts, we give these gifts to you today, knowing that you are the Father of all gifts. As we have been abundantly provided for this day and every day, we too give abundantly to the work you would have us do, the work for the church, the work for the poor, and for those who are disenfranchised. We give these gifts to you today with all the honor and glory. Amen.
So this morning, as we are celebrating our fathers and father figures, we have a lot to be joyful for, even when we've had moments of brokenness. We are singing a song called Joy, but it starts with the beauty in my brokenness. I've got true love instead of pain, because that's what God can bring us, and I think that is definitely something to be joyful about. It's a simple song. It's multiple phrases that get repeated, so as soon as you hear it once, you're going to be ready to sing it again. So please join in. Clap along with us as we go. It is a song of joy. Let's go.
There's beauty in my brokenness. I've got true love instead of pain. There's freedom though you captured me. I've got joy instead of mourning. Let's go again. There's beauty in my brokenness. I've got true love instead of pain. There's freedom though you've captured me. I've got joy instead of mourning. You give me joy.
For just a moment, before we receive the benediction, I do want to invite forward Lydia and Steve Meyer. They have been members of our church. Well, I don't even know how long you've been members. I should have known that off the top of my head. They're like, I don't know.
Okay. So even they don't know.
That's all good. 12-ish years. And been wonderful leaders of the congregation as well. Steve was our SPRC chair last year. He has passed that on to Laura. Lydia is serving as one of our finance committee members. They have been amazing leaders in our church. They are moving next weekend.
Wow.
Yeah. So I didn't want to let them just sneak off without us saying, we love you. We love your family. And you will be missed. Sorry. We're going to pray God's blessing over them. Can you reach out your hands in blessing too? God, we give you thanks for the Meyer family, and we ask that you would just pour out your love upon them. We give you thanks for the journey that we've gotten to share with them, for their lives and their family and their love that they have shared with us. We ask you to continue to bless them along their journey. Help them to find a community of faith that upholds and supports them, where they can grow in their faith and continue to love and serve you and others. Keep us connected across space and distance, for we are truly family. Bless us all as we continue to journey in this fabulous game of life. Amen. Amen. God bless you. We invite you to join us in the social hall. There are some games on tables, and they actually, the Myers provided some of those games, which is fabulous. And if you didn't play Game of Life yet, it'll be there. Let us go out into our day with joy.
And feedback.
And feedback. Let us go with joy, the joy of the Lord, which is our strength that carries us through the good and the bad days of life. May we go with grace, trusting that God is with us on the journey, and go with the love of God outpoured. Know that you are loved, and share that love with others. May God's grace go with you. Amen.
You haven't seen me till you've seen me filled with joy.
Let's try that again.
One. Till you've seen me filled with joy. You haven't seen me till you've seen me filled with joy. You haven't seen me till you've seen me filled with joy. Joy forevermore. Joy.
Soul.